Played 10 matches throughout this four-week period, and eventually the top four of the six teams move on to compete in a single elimination, straight to the point format there for the ultimate prize pool. So we're looking forward to obviously seeing. You can kind of say we're halfway through, kinda, not really, because if you look at the standings, you know, teams have only played anywhere between 3 and 4 matches. There have been a couple matches that have been rescheduled, so thus a little bit to do with that, but also the later part of the season a little bit heavier as far as the amount of matches that the teams are playing. Anyways, with that said, we got our first match up here for this week, and today, Reason Gaming going to be taking on Bad Monkey Gaming here in a best out of three. Before we get too much into it, I want to introduce my co-caster here. Got the one and only Super KGE going to be joining. How's it going, man?
Hey, it's going good.
Going good, yeah. It's good to have you back. It's I don't know what it is, man, but it just seems like you always happen to be around when casting some BMG especially. So welcome back to cast some BMG here.
Thank you. In my opinion, I want to be casting these matches because they're the best team right now.
Yeah,
I can learn a few things here and there now as I'm a drafter.
Well, yeah, speaking of that, so we picked up on that. You're the new drafter for Team X. How's that been going?
Not too good, actually. Like, I need to learn some things.
Oh, come on.
Like, it's going okay, I guess, but I just need to be, like, in my opinion, that we got out-drafted a few games.
Yeah.
So
take some time.
Yeah. I think it's going to be okay in a few weeks from now.
There you go. Well, yeah, you guys are obviously, hey, you're in a fairly good spot right now. Again, I was just showing the standings, so I'll pull them up here once again. You're technically tied for second right now at this point. 6 points in total. You, Sync Esports, and Rexars, actually, will have 6 points. The Last of Us, with 4 points down, they're not doing too shabby. They managed a victory, even. Reason Gaming at the bottom with only 2 points so far through three matches. So, yeah, they've only played 3 matches compared to other teams, most of them playing 4, but still, not expecting them to be all the way down at the bottom here of these of the standings earlier on in this cycle here. So I'm kind of curious. This is a big match for them because they can make a big statement here, not only for their self-esteem, but to also knock out BMG. BMG has yet to lose a single game, let alone a series here. That's why they're so far ahead of everyone else. Do you think Reason Gaming has a chance here today, Super KG?
Yeah, of course. Like, I remember, like, when we played, when I was still part of BMG, like, we lost once in a while to them, so. But I guess now they have Limp, and he's so much better than me, then there's no way they're going to lose.
That's not true, Super KG. That's not true. Different skill sets.
I think we play kind of different. He's playing more passive than me, I think.
But yeah. You're more fun to watch, I'll just say that.
Yeah. Yay.
Yay. all right. So with that said, anyways, we're moving along here. So let's actually focus on the game now and see what's going on here. The bans. It was Ophelia, Kronos, Rhapsody, and Pharaoh coming out. Pharaoh's being banned every now and then. I mean, respecting, I guess, Zane's Pharaoh hero, but also is Pharaoh just a hero that teams are not liking to face against just overall more, or is it player-specific, you think?
I think it. In this case, I think it's more player-specific against Zane. He's really a good Pharaoh, in my opinion.
Yeah.
But I think also it's like it's worth banning, because right now there's not too much jungling heroes, in my opinion, that's being used. So there's more of a tri-lane or dual lanes, and then Pharaoh is really good, especially against tri-lanes. So you can put him in like solo mid or something, and then if they try to dive your tri-lane or something, mm-hmm. he has TPS in, and then there's return kills every single time. So, in my opinion, he's a really good hero now in the current meta. So,
yeah.
I like the ban.
All right. So, he's banned out. And now, these picks, we're waiting for the final pick here from BMG before the next year bans. But we went Puppet Master into Drunken Master, Torturer to Empath, and then Devourer coming out from Reason Gaming. And now it's on BMG to see who they're going to finish off with. Already teams down at that extra time right there. They were waiting initially because I think ProBusk was still AFK, so they wanted to make sure that he was back. So they were intentionally perhaps delaying it, but still. Not much extra time left, but they go with Wretched Hag. Not really a huge surprise there for BMG. But that was interesting because they were right-clicking Swiftblade. They decided not to go with it, and then Reason Gaming immediately banned Swiftblade. with the ban. So just some insight there, perhaps, of maybe what was to come. I don't know if BMG's been playing Swiftblade recently, but
They play him once in a while, especially offensive try lane. They never really play him in another way, in my opinion. As it's a really good, like, especially against Puppet Master, he just spins if they get one stun on him.
Yeah.
Yeah, they can't really stop Sylphane by then, so.
All right, well, he's not going to be an option here because of that. So, Nymphora and a Parasite now being panned out, so more jungle options taken away, at least the second one, really. Ophelia, of course, the first one in the initial bans. I want to get your thought real quickly on Kronos, especially you being a drafter now. There's been a lot of talk. Flensmeister, especially, he's been very open about this hero just needs to be fixed, and the idea of teams even wanting to just agree to ban this hero. Do you think it's almost at that state, or you think people are overreacting?
I think it can be at that stage, though, because I feel like the hero is a bit too, like, it's way too strong, in my opinion, right now. There's only one support, in my opinion, that actually can keep him out, and that's, like, Torture. Like, if you have a duel lane, you're going to lose the lane, because he's going to get too much levels, because there's no way you can keep him out. Mm-hmm. And then he can just roll mid and have the stun ready. So I think just a like, small change to him is going to be making him like be decent again.
Okay.
Right now, he's a bit too strong, in my opinion.
I will say the balance team—they're very aware. They do have changes in mind as far as what's going to be happening. That's the best. I don't even know specifics myself, but I know that's obviously been passed along. They are very aware. Again, people like the balance team itself, Pandaruru especially—he watches pretty much all these matches when it comes to the competitive scene. So, we'll see. We'll see as far as Kronos is concerned. But anyways. Back to the game here. We got the bans finishing off as Keeper, Kraken, Electrician. So BMG actually taking out Keeper the Forest. Is Keeper really a threat? I feel like Keeper hasn't really been picked up a whole lot lately, but taking him away here.
Yeah, I find that also a bit strange. I haven't seen him. I saw him. We played against him once. I don't remember what team it was.
Mm-hmm.
And I didn't feel like it was that big of an impact. They played him as a jungler then, if I'm not too wrong. And I feel like you can't really suicide him anymore. Like, you can, of course, but it's not that strong, so.
Yeah.
I don't.
What? Where did that come from? Succubus coming out here. And is that going to be a farming Succubus here? I mean.
They could put him solo mid, I guess. Or they can also have a Trialing with Succubus to set up the hook if they want to go a Devourer Succubus Engineer Trialing.
Yeah.
And have a Torture solo and Puppet solo. They can do so much with their lineup, so.
Oh, jeez. A little bit different on both sides. Poliwag Priest to finish off for BMG. Almost, it looks like they're going to be running as a secondary support here. Yeah, Handskin. Get it ready up I got a couple things I want to bring up. First off, Succubus against a hero like a Drunken Master, I almost feel like that's a little bit of an over-the-top, like, you don't want that, but at the same time, she has her other pluses, of course, so I guess it's not too big of a deal. But what do you think about the way things finished here?
I feel like Succubus is an okay pick, I guess, but the team overall is not that good against Drunken Master, so if Drunken Master gets a really good start, I think they're going to have a very, very hard time to stop him. So I think their main goal from leading is to shut him down, and the other ones is like, no problems, because they have so much luck down from the other heroes.
Yeah.
And the Poliwag pick is, I guess it's okay, because they're going to go dual lane short, dual lane mid, and then suicide. So I think that's okay. If Legion is going to try lane now, I think it might be a problem, though, with Poliwag support, as he's not that strong.
Yeah.
So.
You don't think he's a strong support? I mean, he has obviously a lot of crowd control and.
Yeah, well, he is a strong support, and if you want to like play against the suicide and stuff like this, but in a tri lane,
okay,
I don't feel like he's good enough. There's other supports that is way better, in my opinion.
Fair enough, but we are gonna see at least the Legion team 4 to 5. Hero Succubus is gonna be playing solo bottom from the looks of it, at this point, headed down there and. Looking like that's going to be the plan. So even if they do a trial lane, it's not going to involve Succubus, apparently. Instead, it'll involve the others, but not even certain if that's going to be the case. But look at that very interesting ward placed by Hans. He got up there quickly, placed a very insightful ward of sight. I guess that's the point. And making sure to get any information, at least from the beginning, and then eventually so on. So that also probably leads you to believe that they're expecting a very aggressive lane up here.
Mm-hmm.
which is the case, it looks like. So they're gonna do it with Puppet Master, though. So Torture, Puppet Master, and Engineer are gonna be up here. Devo is gonna solo mid instead. You like that decision?
Yeah, I think it's alright. Devar just needs levels early. I mean, it doesn't matter if he gets a lot of farm.
Yeah.
Like, it's good, of course, but he doesn't really need it. So I kind of like this.
Alright. Well, so definitely, again, kind of a somewhat interesting lane set up here. A little bit different, and a couple of interesting hero picks on top of that. So looking forward to see how this progresses. But right off the bat, Torture is like, okay, no point for me to be up here against a solo Wretched Hag, so... Gonna transition middle. How do you think this middle lane should play out now? You got a Diva Torture versus a Drunken Empath.
I guess it's all about the hooks. It's gonna be a hard time to kill the Drunken Master unless he jumps away and they get a hook back. But I feel like Legion should win the lane though. They have the upper hand in my opinion. But
yeah.
Both teams are gonna do great in my. Like, they're both gonna be able to farm.
So it's just
gonna be a back and forth.
Yeah, keep an eye on that. And then. The very interesting one, again, this bottom lane. You got an aggressive dual lane, Poliwag and Madman, versus a solo Succubus. So, I don't know if this was intended on either side for this to be the matchup, but, I mean, it is obviously the matchup in the end. And ooh, top lane, Bloodlust kill. Look at that, Puppet Master and Engineer. They go in and take out Wretched Hag up there. I saw it happening. I went to go click on it right as I did. All of a sudden, he's dead. So, I assume, though, just your good crowd control, obviously, Puppet Show between the Puppet's Hold and then even the kicks down on top of that to secure the kill. Did you catch that by chance?
Nah, I was watching bottom at the moment, but I think like that lane is way too strong for Hag.
Yeah.
Hag is not going to get anything up there. It's, if I don't remember wrong, I think you were... No, I don't think it was you casting, but someone casted a game when the Flint Smiths played the Hag. I think it was against the Puppet Master lane.
Okay.
And he had like 120 GPM after.
Yeah.
So I think this is going to be the case for Fusti as well in this game. He's going to have nothing.
You see what he's doing here. I mean, going to stack the yellow camp and just going to try to farm that with that level 1 sonar scream. At least the best that they can. So yeah, when you see a Wretched Hag doing that, you know that the lane matchup is not a friendly one. In the end. Engineer's been sitting here middle lane. Here we go. There's the stun. The hook back out on the Drunken Master. Nice wall off right there on the Devourer though. And that's definitely going to be the big difference maker in the end. So. Obviously, Drunken Master, somewhat difficult to kill, mainly for the stagger at this point. But at least the attempt was there. But Engineer's actually just all the way to the bottom, like back to the middle, though. Devourer actually gets pulled in right there, but he is going to be fine as well. So it's just some back and forth harassment. Nice wall. Cancels the regen rune, actually. On ProBusk, he got a little too aggressive. Oh, no. Okay,
it's
that's
Ion Stone.
Oh, wow. I assume that was just a bottle. Okay, how about that? And then that happens. Succubus kills himself with his Mesmerize. So looks like he was maybe about to die and is able to deny himself in the end. So I guess good play from Zane, as I missed another kill there. But that is a benefit of Succubus, of course. What about that, though? Ion Stone, I think he had that right off the bat, too, on Torturer.
Yeah, he bought it on level 1. Which is kind of weird, in my opinion. As it doesn't spawn a rune or anything.
And
he tries to pick up the rune twice with his Iron Stone, which doesn't work.
Wonder if he knew that. So, yeah, this is kind of warning going on. But anyway, so again, back to the bottom lane, though. So Succubus able to at least deny himself. But Engineer is down here now. Has made his way down here. So we'll see maybe if the Legion team can make a move. But for the time being, Madman's having a great time. 18-8 on Jonasavant here at this bottom lane. Surprising at all, or expected?
Yeah, well, it's expected that Sergo was a duel lane against Succubus. So I guess that's kind of expected, but I felt like Zane shouldn't be able to die there.
Yeah.
I think he must have done something wrong. I was not checking, so I can't say anything about it. But.
Yeah. We're both apparently pretty bad at catching these kills here.
Yeah.
Top lane, again, Puppet Master, though, he is just dominating. Look at that farm. Not only working off a Bloodlust kill, but just... Imba Boy doing his thing, 28-13 now, 435 gold per minute. Okay, so now the usual question, you're 4.5 minutes in here. If you're the Hellborn team, if you're BMG, when do you got to address this guy, right? Because, okay, as I say that, they're starting to go up there, but you can't let him just continue to free farm, obviously. So look at this rotation here for BMG. It's in Poliwag top, actually.
Yeah, I think they need to do something about him, because if it's... Puppet Master snowballs, it's really hard to like come back in the game unless you win a big teamfight. Mm-hmm. And I feel like Legion has the upper hand in teamfights too, like early levels, so yeah, that's going to be a rough time if they want to try for something like that. So I think they're doing what they need to do, address him.
You do see right now, I mean, Puppet Master kind of forced in that spot of we can't really go up once again, so hey, they are preventing the farm all of a sudden, and obviously that's mid-lane? A very good sign. Yeah, mid lane stagger away, though. He is going to be fine once again, so...
I think Probus is, like, hooking way too early. He needs to wait for the hook until the stagger comes out and then hook him back. Mm. That's the only way they can come, so...
That does make sense. I mean, you can see... Obviously, for the second, if he's able to stagger away, then not much more you can do to follow up, unless you have the stun to follow up. There's a couple of stuns, even, which they kind of do now, but Limp's playing it pretty passive, obviously, so don't think they're going to be getting that opportunity they're perhaps looking for. Madman's farm is still obviously pretty damn good. In fact, he goes like first item mana tube. Interesting. So, oh, back to the middle lane, though, up here to the top rune. Actually, Dragon Master kegs on Will, and he tries to get away, but no, the hook in, right in the face, gets the kill. Torture will fall in the process, but a 1-for-1 in favor right now of Recent Gaming, and it's going to be a 2-for-1, as Poliwhirl Priest also got caught between a rock and a hard place at the same time. So, good rune control coming out right there, and really just the race to it, and obviously ends up in the favor of Recent Gaming. So, their start, definitely the better here against BMG.
Yeah, they're looking great right now. If they just keep this up and try to like maintain the freeform on Puppet Master, they're going to be doing really good. Bottom lane, Limp is roaming now, though, so this might be a kill on Sane here.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, he's dead.
Yeah. I mean, he's going to mesmerize again, but yeah, it's not going to be too effective this time in the end. He does have ultimate and his Heartache. He's going to use the Heartache right there. Kickstun comes out. Holy crap, he is somehow still alive. He actually may get away from this. Oh, my God, he's going to live. Zane doing a great, great escape job, and actually now Limp's the one in trouble. In comes a chain of reactions. He does the lunge right there, but it doesn't matter. Super KG, what just happened?
There was a misplay from Limp, in my opinion. I don't know what he did there. Like, they should have just, like, keep chasing, and he should have staggered in front of the succubus so he can't walk through the trees there. So I think it was just a small misplay, I guess. From both of them. Also, Jonas doesn't even have boots there, so it's just kind of hard for him to chase up as he could only afford one barrel roll and one stall.
Yeah.
Oh, top lane.
Yeah, caught the tail end of that. Actually, Imbapoy does get credit for the kill right there. The creep wave, I believe, in the end actually ended up killing the voodoo puppet off, so he does get credit for the kill, but he died before that as he was going for it, so definitely still well in favor of BMG as far as that exchange. Was concerned, but that also gets to a point now. If you're Recent Gaming, you know, this long lane Puppet Master, I would think you may want to look to change that up here. Maybe send him bottom, you think?
They can do that, yeah. Then they need to, in my opinion, have the Devour top lane with an offensive tri lane and just have some wards so they can see where the BMG supports are.
Yeah.
So then they can swap around their supports how they want. Recent, that is.
All right, so Drunken Master, he is level 6 now. No ghost launcher just yet. Yeah, the hook is going to hit this time. Kegstun comes out, he has a stagger, but it doesn't matter this time around, so that's what we're talking about. As long as they can get that ground control off and get the job done. So good initial stun by Torture to set that up, and obviously Probusk easily able to follow the process. So there's going to be a foot to pause here, but actually Madman might be in some trouble as I say that. You got Succubus coming in, is level 6, so Succubus hold is ready to go here. As far as that's concerned.
The only way they're going to be able to kill him now is if Jonas runs in front of the to the creeps and then puppet hold. Mm-hmm. If Sane just tries to walk up there, Jonas is going to see him before and he's just going to stalk away. So it's all up to Sane if he's smart enough to stand in there and wait.
Well, so... Okay, hopefully... I mean, okay. We do see Madman here. Again, he went the mana tube, by the way. I mentioned that earlier. So that obviously will lead into a sustainer, most likely, unless it's just something really awkward, like the Fresh Pro Storm Spirit. But no, probably sustainer here going to be coming out. And that will most likely be a null stone, I would think. I mean...
It can be an awesome, but also a rune cleaver, as he really likes to go into rune cleaver. As he had a really good start, I think he was thinking about going rune cleaver, but yeah. He might have changed his mind now, though.
Okay.
And Sanus.
Yep, there we go. There's the hold. Puppet Master just going to apply some auto attacks. This is definitely dead Batman. There's no way. The crowd control is going to be way too powerful, especially by himself. So, yeah, that's obviously a huge strength of this Legion team. I mean, I know we kind of knew that both teams knew that coming in. We knew that everyone knew this coming in, but just to reiterate the obvious, it's a lot of crowd control here on the Legion side. And Succubus and Puppet Master, especially those two alone, provide plenty of it.
They get these in the whole team alone.
Yeah, they can take care of business. Middle lane once again, Trucking Master. Nice stun from Empath right there. Using the Essence Link, of course, to actually get the stun off. So Probusk not going to get the kill at least just yet. He does still have support coming in, though. And if he lands another hook right here, followed by those chain reactions, he wants that angle. Limp needs to be careful. Yeah, he got it. Oh, he should have went for it. Nope, he's not doing it.
He's too afraid.
Yep. You would have hit that, right? That was
easy. Yeah, of course.
That was easy. All right, so not going to get it right there. Polymar Priest has kind of been farming up the top lane in the meantime, just kind of getting any farm he can. He's a struggling one big time in this game overall, as far as his impact. But he's almost level 6 at the same time. What do you think of his build, by the way? You know, being a secondary support, Polymar has to actually hold that thought, though. Bottom lane, Imbaboy is in a lot of trouble. Holy crap, I don't even know if Bat Blast was necessary, but... Hey, guaranteed the job done. And on Puppet Master, especially in this case, you want to make sure that is the case. So, good collapse on a Puppet Master there. And movement from Fousey. Again, this is a guy that was having a horrible start because of the lane setup. And now he has 300 gold per minute.
Yeah, it's all about that. The lane, like the movement from Hanskin went up top and then made him free farm for like 3 or 4 minutes. And now, like, he could keep farming top if he wanted to, but he decided to gank bottom, which was good, of course. Mm-hmm. So I guess he's just going to go back top now and keep farming.
Succubus might be in trouble. You got Poliwag and Empath nearby, but...
And Hag coming in.
Okay, he's... Yep, going to be porting in right here. So, yeah, Succubus, if he does keep going, he's probably going to die. Yeah, but he doesn't. Oh, Zane.
Heads up, Zane.
No, he's dead. There goes the easy jump, and there's the easy follow-up for the kill. Eventually, there you go. I was going to talk about Polywar Priest, though. He is level 6 now, by the way, so he's got those wards. But what do you think of his build? I was getting at, because being the secondary support, why not maybe go more of a crowd control heavy build rather than maxing out that electric jolt? Do you think that still makes sense?
When I play him as a support, I normally go maxing out W and E and have like only 1 in Q, or like... I don't know why I have even one in Q. I don't even need that either.
Now that I think about it, that's kind of stupid. Madman actually is going to get picked up at the bottom lane. So tower on top of the Madman kill. That's big for reason.
Yeah, they're going to do a lot of damage on the next tower as well because they have a catapult already there.
So. Yeah.
Top lane tower though, they're putting out on the wards.
That's going to be a tower, push. Yeah, looks like he's not going to do anything about that in the end. So. How's item progression coming? Imbaboy going the aggressive. Yeah, he just finished an Assassin Shroud right there. And that's going to be coming out. Yeah, middle lane Drunken Master is going to be fine, though. Or did he finish it? I still think he needs a broadsword, actually, but about the pattern first for some reason. But Assassin Shroud first. So going the aggressive route here. No Whispering Helm. You like it?
It's really good, especially against Wretched Hag, because he's like one of the few heroes that like really farms dangerously all the time and takes waves really fast. So if Puppet Master can be there like every single time, he's gonna solo him, and he won't really run with anyone to farm. So I think it's a pretty decent pickup here. I like the pickup because they're gonna have other heroes that can farm the jungle and take the stacks with Torture and Engineer and maybe Devour. Mm-hmm. So he doesn't need to be that much in the jungle.
All right, so, yep, he's got the Assassin Shroud now on the way here, as he just purchased the Broadsword on top of it. So, other farm, I mean, obviously he's up there, but also Devour is up there. He's having a great time. Nearly 400 gold per minute himself on Probusk. I'm looking at his items. I feel like he should have something else. What's on the courier? There you go. It's a portal key. So that answers that. How about that? The first item portal key here. Mr. Devour yourself, Super KG. You think that's the best choice?
Yeah, I like it. I like it here.
Yeah. Torture gets picked up. Nice hook on Wretched Hag. The follow-up's going to be successful. Actually, Empath is also inside, so now she's also going to be in trouble. This exchange well in favor of Reason Gaming in the end. Down goes Empath. A big hook from Probusk. to kind of turn things around. That was 0 for a kill on the main support Torturez. Oh, Madman's also going to get caught. The puppet show and the hold in the face. Kexon comes out. The energy field to really secure the job. Reason Gaming, man. They're up and quite in a good spot here early on. 14 minutes in, and we're looking at a 5,300 gold lead, 3,800 experience lead. This is BMG's got a. What does BMG need to do? They're in a tough spot.
Yeah, they're really far behind now because they should have been like quite even, in my opinion, if they're like doing good. So right now, I guess what they should try to do is like get peck offs on someone. I'm not too like. I guess the Hanska needs to be the one that's roaming a lot because he has all the CC. Yeah, I don't think they should like try and push though. That's, in my opinion, very bad, especially against Devara with Porky. He can be positioning himself really good and just get a good hook off.
Yeah. And if you're Reason Gaming here, it seems like they're just going to keep. I mean, not the items are speaking for that. The Assassin Shroud first on Puppet Master, the Porta Key early on in Devour. This is a very aggressive makeup, and especially with the items that they're going for here. So, yeah, if you're Reason, you're going to keep that throttle on, and that puts BMG in that tough spot, definitely.
Top lane.
What are we going to see up here? Devour just going to dive right on top of Poliwag Priest. He has the hook, but no, the Hex comes out. He has the hook, but he couldn't get it off in time. And yeah, the supporting cast comes in. Oh, he hits Madman. He went for it, but no,
the
Madman gets in the way. But yeah, what's going on down here? Regidag does get picked off. Drunken Master also going to fall victim. So again, we've seen this several times this game. It seems like a pick happens for BMG, but the outcome is better for Reason in the end. And now they're going to push. I mean, BMG undefeated in games coming into this. They had four series they've played so far. Haven't dropped a single game. Reason Gaming at the bottom of the standings. They haven't had the best starts of the season. Yet here they are on the verge of taking the first game over BMG and doing it in decisive fashion. Empath is also going to get caught in a bad spot. And she will get bursted down eventually. Heartache assisting
and
with
so
that.
And so is Hanskin.
From Succubus, and so is Hanskin. They just keep getting caught one by one. They're trying to assist, and it's just not working. Don't keep going. Don't keep going. Wretched Egg is going to keep going in right here, as well as Drunken Master. So we'll see what happens now. Drunken Master jumps on a Torturer. Succubus being locked down. Doesn't have her cooldowns really ready. For the time being, Bat Blast comes out by Drunken Master. Falls. Madman's turn now, apparently. He wants to get some action. He's going to get, they get the one kill on a Torturer. But at what cost? Wretched Hag goes down. It doesn't stop, man. It doesn't stop.
Yeah. It's like one for one trades all the time.
Yeah. Well, I think Reason Gaming's happy.
Yeah, like, they're killing the enemy cores while they're losing only their support all the time. So they're really happy right now.
Mm-hmm. They are in a very, very good spot.
I don't think they should try to like take fights like this all the time. They need to be more heroes when they try to fight. Also, like Madman only has a sustainer. That's like not too shabby, I guess, but he's not that good in team fights if you go items like this, as he has really low hit points.
Mm-hmm.
Like a hook on him is like almost half his hit points, so that's not too nice.
Yeah, you rarely see it, especially nowadays. I mean, BMG, they're in a spot of, there's not a whole lot of answers. I mean, it seems like they maybe got one fight left in there, but this is not going to help either. Probus gets a big hook once again, and Mammoth will fall. Drunken Master trying to assist. They get the counter kill on a Puppet Master, actually, so that's a good one for one right there in their favor. But Devour's looking for another hook. I don't think he's going to get it, though. Yeah, they're going to fall back this time, or maybe no. Portal keys in, going for the all-in hook right there, but unsuccessful. So finally, a little bit of sign of life there for BMG, but again, it came at the cost of Madman. So it's not like the biggest best outcome ever. And this is interesting. Poliwag Priest gets jumped, and Wretched Hag just has to watch. He's like, I want to help you, man, but I don't have a stun. Nothing that he can do.
Oh, Hag.
Oh, jeez.
This is looking grim.
I think Reason's going to pull away. If they haven't already, that is. If you're a PMG, I think you're almost at the point of let's just move on to game two. Because this is, quickly getting out of hand.
Is Limp going to die from patience here?
That's close. He goes back in. Jeez. Living life on the edge. Only way to do it. All right, yeah, he's going to be fine. Again, there's not really answers. You're definitely going to need mistakes to happen from Reason, maybe overextending themselves. But again, with the way they're playing, the items advantage that they have and everything, it's just not very likely at this rate. So
if Reason game is just going to be like, keep upping the pressure and push tower after tower, I think there's like no chance for PMT to pull back because they don't have that much like AoE crowd control. They have none.
Yeah.
So they only have some single targets CC, but that's not even enough. So if they get a shrunk enough on Imba Boy and on Sane, I think there's no way they're going to be able to take a team fight.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's true. Yeah, it's. I mean, I'm trying to think back to this game. I don't know. I mean, Reason Game has obviously just been playing very well as a team and taking advantage of their lineup and everything as they should be, but. You know, where did this go wrong for BMG? Is this just them just simply getting outplayed? I mean, were the lanes, I guess, weren't the best for them, but... Oh, top lane, actually. We do have a little bit of initiation coming out right here. Empath Wall going to block off Torture a bit, and Torture's going to be left behind to fall victim to the Hellborn team. So, good pick off there from BMG, at least, in Reason Gaming, though. Smart play again. The rest of them just fall back, not going to force the issue.
I think they could have forced the issue, though, because the engineer could just run up there and ulti, and that would save... Or maybe not even save him, but they would get a return kill on public or on them. I mean, but he dies here anyways.
Holy crap! Not often a drunken master just drops that quickly, but that happened. Devourer's in a bad spot though. He's gonna be locked down. So again, a lot of these one for ones going on. But the overall, you got a 21-11 hero kill lead in favor of Reason Gaming. So obviously, it's been going better for them in the big picture. In the end, so yeah, I guess, you know, this game definitely not going to be ending as quickly at this point, and BMG is, you know, doing their best to keep things calm and slow things down a little bit, but Wretched Hag, what is she at? She's got 337 gold per minute, she's got a Light Brand here, 1640 gold saved up, so she is on her way to that Grimmoor power. That is, that's coming, and then Madman, again, I'm still very, I think at this point, definitely you just go Nullstone here, right? Rune Cleaver's just too late, or still could be ruined, do you think?
I think he's gonna go for relaxing because it look by the looks of it, I think they just want to like keep farming and like push out the lanes and don't try to take queen team fights, and that's what they should do. So I feel like a rune axe is not too bad.
Yeah.
But also Nullstone is really good against their team because then he has time to react and get his stalk off in time. But if they have an eye, it won't really matter because they have so much that can lock him down anyways.
Mm-hmm.
So both are good, but I think he might go Rune Cleaver because that's the elements we're talking about.
true that. All right, so we'll see what he does eventually go for. You were mentioning the Shrunken Head on Puppet Master though, and that's well on its way. 2,200 more gold saved up. So Imba Boy is definitely going to be building one of those in the near future. Yeah, he buys the Warhammer in fact already to help assist with some damage here. And again, eventually follow that into the full Shrunken Head. Devourer, though, and the rest of his teammates really just kind of looking around for kills. And hell, even Puppet Master is going to continue to join them, of course, as they're just pushing in the middle lane here. Devourer thinks he's found something. He's found a couple. The hook's going to miss right there. But if you're the Hellborn team, you want to keep running because look at the support coming. And Empathy gets nom nom nommed right there. Drunken Master, the quick lunge to save his teammate, and it will get away as well. So very good teamwork right there from BMG, actually, and saving one another. But Reason is just going to make their way back to the middle lane and continue to push, but meanwhile, kind of pushing the top lane. So again, BMG being a little crafty here and trying to claw their way back.
This is what they should do, like just try to avoid them all the time and push tower. So I think it's really good from Hanskin. It's using his ward on every single tower they can get. So I think they're trying to catch up now. The XP and gold is pretty much the same though. As like they're getting back on XP because Reason Game is just training so much right now, but it doesn't really matter in my opinion. They have the levels they need. I think it's only Engineer that needs 11 and then they're good to go.
Yeah.
It's gonna be a teamfight bottom now, but it looks a bit dull.
Yeah, well, that's what BMG wants. I mean, they are really going full force here. Holy crap, if they pick these off right here, this could be huge for BMG. They're going to get the fine. Big wall up from Empath coming out. He's inside of Madman right now. And Puppet Master's just simply trying to run this whole time right here. He is going to be fine. The Assassin's Child comes out. Torture's going to be left behind once again to be the fallen victim. So, again, I mean, BMG, that was a big chase. Like, but that could have been a lot better. So, Reason Gaming, you know, again, they lose Torture. Not the end of the world, though, for them. And but I don't know. The more these last like 3 or 4 minutes, it's been changing my mind a little bit personally as far as BMG and their chances. Because as you were saying, you know, evade some fights, you know, find some opportunities like that to eventually get five group of us five and at least get one pick. And I mean, their late game is strong, man.
Yeah, I think they should have went for the bottom tower though. It's really low, and Puppet Master wasn't be able to fight as he was also really low. So I think they should have just went for the tower. But I think it's okay also because. As long as they get like space to farm more and more.
Yeah.
And that's the only thing they need. As Drunken Master and Hag is a really good plus Madman, that is. Mm-hmm. It's really, really good late game potential.
Yeah, this that's what I'm thinking here. BMG, they got a very, very, very strong late game. So as comfortable as a lead Reason Gaming has had earlier on in this game, they're not finishing the job just yet. And that could come back to bite them in the ass if they're not careful. So we'll see what BMG is able to make happen. Again, Jonas the Fan especially, he has enough for the Rune Cleaver. That's what he was going to be going for here. So maybe finish off this creep wave and see where he goes from there. But again, he's saving up quite a bit of gold. And I don't know. I wouldn't be surprised if he even just goes straight into like a Shrunken Head next, to be honest.
Mm-hmm.
Just sits on this. It's not like a sustainer's a bad item to have itself. It's some nice plus damage. And, you know, the regen's obviously good for a hero like Madman.
In my opinion, if you want to go for a Shrunken, I think you should go with the Rune Cleaver first, because that makes him be able to farm so much, and I don't think Legion's going to be able to push base.
Yeah.
But then he got the ult.
Untouchable OP.
Yeah. He should know that, though, that he can't hook in.
Yeah. Yeah, so proc twice right there. He tried to use his ulti, and then he's like, I'm going to try to hook you. Wait a second. That doesn't work either. Yes, that counts as the single target there, so... In the end, Drunken Master does get away. Good job by Limp right there. Definitely not one of his better games, but at least staying alive right there. And obviously, again, saved his teammate a couple minutes ago as well. But again, you can see that Reason Gaming, they're very aware that, I'm sure, they have the aggressive mindset here, or have had it, and will continue to do so, and looking for more opportunities. But again, BMG's playing the evasive game, so... Not going to give it to them, and instead they're just going to push the top tower in. It's an outer tower, not the biggest deal in the world for BMG. It's going to happen, so... Trade other towers, and that's what they're going to do bottom, it looks like.
I think they're playing this really good. Or maybe Sync is playing it too bad, I guess.
Reason, you mean?
Yeah. Yeah, Reason, I mean.
Yeah.
As they can force them back really easy.
Oh,
but
man.
Instead they...
Engineer gets picked off. Devour's able to hook in right back, but now Devour's by himself right here. He portal keys away really quickly, but Succubus also comes in, and she's going to die as well. So, I don't know, man. I think the tides have turned.
Yeah, it feels like they're throwing, I guess. Like, they're not too sure what they're going to do. That's the feeling I get right now. In my opinion, they should have just like kept going mid and forced them back instead, because then they need to be like, then they're 5 versus 5. And like now as they try to do this, they TP'd one guy, and then the other guy started TPing.
Yeah.
And then the tower went down, and the two guys still left mid lane, they can't TP anymore. So, I think they're playing... Like, they're not communicating enough, they're not sure what they're gonna do.
Mm-hmm.
So,
yeah.
I guess it's up to Saintrax to get his team together.
Yeah, he's kind of that, we believe he's more that team captain. Obviously, Imbaboy's a drafter in the end, but... Definitely gives the commands and whatnot during the game, I'm sure. But this is BMG all of a sudden. 31 more 100 gold on Wretched Dagon. The Nullstone finish on Madman. So he does go the Nullstone in the end and decide to go that route as far as that's concerned. Again, it is one of those funky games because there's a lot that it negates, but there's also a lot that could just easily take it off going into it, from the tablets to things like Agonizing Bonds and whatnot. But at the same time, you get a Shrunken Head as well. Then it becomes very difficult. Then that also prevents Succubus Hold from even being effective against it in that case. So, it makes sense, especially when he gets the Shrunken Head, it will make a lot more sense, I think. But I assume that's going to be next in line.
Yeah, hopefully he's gonna get it. I don't think he should go anything else, in my opinion.
Yeah.
And then maybe after that he should go Basher, so he can just sit on the Puppet Master, because that's their only damage if they have Shrunkens.
Oh, bottom Terra, that's the last Shadow Terra destroyed, so yeah, you got a Puppet Master now, level 16. If you're Reason here, do you think like this is it? I mean, this is where you're probably going to have your best chance the way this game's going, you think, so.
Yeah, in my opinion, they should have pushed earlier in my opinion also, because Shrunken Master just finished the Shrunken. You don't want a Shrunken Master Shrunken if you want to like have a team fight, or like they don't have a late game. They have so much like early potential and everything. Yeah. So as they also did shut him down really good, they should have went before. Also, Wretched Hag finishes her Shrunken right now, so like it's not too late, but you want to go earlier in my opinion.
Well, again, they're going to fall back after pushing that last Shadow Terra. Obviously, BMG was ready to defend, so understandable. Not going to bang their head against the wall at the door right there, but another tablet picked up. They got three tablets over here on the Legion side as Nui grabs his, playing the Engineer right here. So, obviously, an effective item to have for many, many of reasons. The Madman, he's got an Invis. Okay, I was going to say, is he stalking? No, he's got an Invis rune, so he's going to be fine here. As Devourer was trying to find it, but... No luck there. Another thing to keep in mind about Succubus, by the way, is that Smitten ability. That's been changed a couple times and a while ago, definitely, but the latest one was the fact that now it reduces all damage. It's not just base damage. It reduces all damage, so magic abilities and everything. So, I mean, you got some good candidates over here, specifically that Wretched Hag I'm looking at. That could be good against. At the same time, though, Shrunken Head removes it, of course, so... probably not going to be the most useful tool in the end, but on paper it definitely has possibility to be good. So we'll see if that comes into play. But look at this sneaky Kongor, and they're going to get it. I don't think BMG has a clue.
I think they know actually, but I don't think they want to fight them. They just want to be able to get as much damage on towers, etc., and push.
Yeah. Well, that's what they're doing. Pushing the top lane up here and not going to get it killed, but they definitely get a response out of Reason Gaming, and the tower does fall very low right there. Down to about 450 life, it looks like. So, and they're going to steal Triple Sack Ancients, or go for it.
I don't think Hanska should have used his ward there, because if Reason Gaming is going to push straight away, he won't have them when they're at the tower.
True. What's going on bottom? Poured out. Drunken Master, actually, he used Untouchable. He tried to pour it out. Wasn't going to happen, though. So he's
does
in a little bit of trouble. What's that?
He used his TP, and he hooked, and that interrupted him. But
did it?
Yeah, but it doesn't move him. But it did interrupt him.
Really? Or I wonder. Maybe the limp like just moved, thinking he was interrupted for some reason. But
yeah, that might be. Because I don't feel like it should interrupt him. Should it?
I don't think it should. No, as we saw earlier, I mean, it's mitigated by the hook, or the hook is mitigated by the untouchable. So, yeah, no, if that's the case, yeah, I kind of caught that as like, he was porting, like, as it just ended, so I'm not even sure, like, are you sure he had it up as he was porting, or did he just use it right after? He probably had it up as he was porting, I'm sure, so.
Yeah, he had the untouchable up all the time, and then the hook came while he was porting and had the untouchable.
I don't know.
Something, I guess he moved on.
Yeah, maybe it just simply was himself that... one of those freak reactions, like, I shouldn't have done that. But hey, he dies. They aren't able to make the biggest response out of it in the end, but still. Get a kill on the Limp right there. And again, 2-7-5. Limp's been a star in the stat line as far as going into... In fact, hopefully by this week and into next week, I'll have more of a visuals to show and everything. But again, from what Limp's definitely been up there for the kills and least deaths and everything. So this game going to change that a little bit, but... yeah, they want to kill right here. Speaking of Limp.
I think they should turn there. With the hook or something, since he's invis.
Yeah.
But I guess they're too afraid that they don't have their torture yet.
Yeah, he's still coming. He's in the background here. He's got a bound eye, though, so... we'll have that to be used to both counter war, but also help them against the Madman, especially. On this Hellborn side. Portal key on Handskin right there. Again, he had a horrible start, but hey, he's now 220 gold per minute, doing solid for secondary support. He's got a tablet and a portal key, more than just fine items. Soul's Bulwark on Devour, that's, I would think more. Well, a mix of also the mid-game, but also obviously assisting damage with your Puppet Master, especially. Currently set to offensive. What did Puppet just buy? A Slayer. All right. Going to be going Savage Mace over a full symbol here, or Genjiro even. You like the Savage choice?
I get it's really good for pushing, but they won't have it while they're pushing. So.
Yeah.
It's not bad. They need damage. And I don't feel like he's going to be able to drop, so... Unless they use everything on him and get a CC off before he's shrunken. So mm-hmm. I'd like to pick up.
Alright, some nice assisted damage there, and they're going to keep keep them at their base, at least, in BMG, but... Again, they got the token of life, a minute and a half now, obviously that changed, remember? 3.4, you got 5-minute token instead of the 7-minute token. Definitely haven't seen that. Oh. There we go. The opening on Dragon Master. The Voodoo Puppet comes out. He hooks him back, though. Devour hooks his teammate back right there. The Bat Blast does hit a couple, but not the biggest follow-up. Big energy field coming out. Mammoth's going to be locked down by the Succubus Hold. They negated the Null Stone, and then the Succubus Hold followed right there. And Mammoth did not stand a chance. He has buyback. Drunken does not, though. Mammoth has buyback, but no Drunken Master buyback. Reason Gaming, are they going to be able to push in here?
I think they are. They still have token on Puppet Master, yeah. So I think they're okay as Hag used Bat Blast and everything there.
There we go. The buyback Madman. He once again is most likely going to fall. Yep, Jonas Van going down right there. The tower is still alive, though. Empath, he is currently mesmerized. Down goes Puppet Master. Token going to come back up, but Wretchedag picking up the kill onto Engineer. Puppet Master still wants to hang around. Not for long, though. His teams are going to start going to fall back because they are getting low on life. Torture gets caught off to the side. The hook right there at the last second, but it was just too late to save the day. So Fousey does end that with a double tap. And, I mean, they even saved the tower. So with the way this game's been going and everything, I think you got to give the win to BMG there overall. But Reason Gaming, I mean, Puppet does stay alive at least.
I think they went in a bit too far. As the token died, they have no damage. So he was down like for 3 seconds there once the token was like he's getting it back up. So that's when they had the chance for BMG to like kill everyone else, and that's what they did.
Yeah.
So I think they shouldn't have went in that far, as like Devour was really far, and also Engineer, and they just melted straight away. Mm-hmm. So I felt like they should have played that a bit safer and just went for the tower instead of trying like going for the kills.
Yeah. Well, so, BMG again though doing enough to hold in there and. You got a Wretched Hag now, 3,900 gold saved up, so we'll probably see a sheep stick coming out on her. Drunken Master, 1,500 gold here. So again, he hasn't had the best farm throughout this whole game, only 245 gold per minute, but still. Gonna keep going the right way here, the positive direction. Jonas and Fan, 0-6-8, that's an interesting stat line right there on Madman. Coming out. Got the more assists than a death, but still no kills on his favor, and that's not helping his farm, I'm sure. But again, he's trying to work towards the Shrunken Head next, but obviously the buyback definitely delaying things. But BMG, they're going to try to be the aggressors now. They obviously know no token or anything like that. In the meantime, bottom tower's pushed in. What do you do? This is interesting. Wards come down. The defensive tower at the top lane, it's going to end up falling right here, but they're already taking out the melee racks here at the bottom side. Drunken Master, he's ready to go in, but down goes the melee racks. And meantime, the top lane, though, Succubus hold on to Wretched Hag, actually. She's going to be locked down. She doesn't have any more mana left. It burns the mana as well. And down goes Hag. That was pretty much worst-case scenario for BMG right there, and it's just continuing,
and they get
apparently. Yep. They get the kill into Drunken. And they're going to get more, it looks like.
Their buybacks are out, though.
Oh, Puppet Master, actually. Yeah, no, he's going to be caught in a bad spot now. Bat Blast coming out. The buybacks are coming through here. For the Hellborn team, nice crit there from Puppet Master, but in the end, he does fall shortly after. He's the Engineer trying to maybe get away right here, but that's not going to happen either. So, again, BMG, they do get some kills in the end, but it took several buybacks, and they lost their melee barracks right there in the end. So, now Reason Gaming, once again, maybe back to being a little more comfortable here.
Yeah, I felt like they overplayed that a bit too much. They should have went back early, in my opinion, BMG, as they lost the melee racks now and didn't get the top lane racks. Mm-hmm. and they use three buybacks there, so that's really rough. If they don't try to if they don't like try to fight for next Kongar, that's what I'm trying to say.
Okay,
they're gonna be really bad.
Good test, I think is what we were looking for. Yeah. Okay, so yeah, the next Kongar, again, definitely usually leads to him in closer games like this, especially later on in the game, so
mm-hmm.
Going to be a big deal.
Also, can you recall me on Skype or something? You're lagging for me.
Yes, I will do. One sec. Come back. Hopefully the stream's fine. Yeah, I'm not getting drop frames or anything. Okay, there we go. Sound better?
Yeah, it's a lot better now.
Okay. Thanks. Good old Skype. Yeah, so again, Kongar going to be a big deal. Redshack, 5,300 gold saved up. He has not bought anything since that Shrunken Head pickup, but I assume the Sheep Stick, though, is going to be full clicked here soon.
Fusi must have been playing really farming, as he has 500 GPM from his really bad start, so I think he's been great this game.
Yeah. He's definitely been the carry, as usual, here for BMG and doing his job there. Shrunken Head is going to be able to be purchased by Madman now. Again, you know, buybacks are important too, but he has enough to buy that Shrunken Head here. So it's going to be interesting to see if any fights happen, to see if he actually does or not, because again, that's a big, big pickup here in this game, especially since he has a Null Stone. Oh, the hook attempt on Empath there. Does miss. He throws a wall up just in case, and yep, Empath is going to survive. Good getaway from Seal Kid right there. Making sure to stay out of harm's way. Souls Borg just finished on Drunken Master, though, by the way.
Mm-hmm. And also a demonic, full demonic on Devourer.
Oh, wow. You think that's necessary? You like that?
Yeah, it's very good, in my opinion, especially against Hellborn. Hag just bought a Sheep Stick, so if they get a pick on him, he won't have a buyback, and that's another set of racks. So
yeah.
He needs to be playing safe now.
So especially with that, again, if you're BMG, I think you get that Shrunken Head at all costs here on Madman. Don't save up for the buyback. Now, obviously, there's no point about it if there's not going to be any action here happening just yet, so might as well keep the goal for now. But that's where if Regent Gaming, you would think, this is their time once again to maybe make something happen. But Kongar is up, so here we go. This is what you were talking about.
Jonas needs... He buys a Shrunken and TP's back.
Okay. He does get it. All right, so the second Kongar kill. No bananas just yet, but still. Just still the token of life alone, of course. Very, very, very powerful. For whoever can get it. You see Snoopy right here. He's trying to get in range to maybe make something happen. He actually places the ward of sight down. So, yeah, they have some good vision now. No bound eye. You know, Empath actually has a bound eye, but they're not going to counter ward this ward of sight up here for the time being, so...
Devourer's looking for Huck.
Yep. He's just waiting for somebody to pop up this hill. Oh, man. I think BMG might be a little aware. Yeah, they popped the bound eye, so they probably are aware now. But Devourer, that's a free kill! Yep, Empath's going to fall right here. Are they going to follow it? Probably not. It's just Empath in the end, but still. Well, they do counter it in the end, but it got them a kill at least. And now without Empath.
Hands can want to go in. Here we go.
Oh, jeez. This is it. The big Black Blast right there. Engineer. He's taking some good damage. Going to be fine, though. Wretched Head going to be locked in initially, but not for long. Succubus, he gets canceled. And now he has a Shrunken Head up. Shrunken Head's up all over the place. They're trying to finish off Kongar. Who got it? Madman got it, actually. Jonas Van picks it up. He has a Shrunken Remember on top of the Null Stone. And he's going ham right here. But in the end, he's the one going to start taking a lot of damage. And he will fall, as so does the rest of BMG. Jonas Van coming up. But the beautiful kicks in right as he does. And Reason Gaming will take the fight, and now they're going to push to the base, and as we said, there's no buybacks across the board. That's probably GG. I think Reason Gaming just did it right there with that Kongar fight. BMG was really focused on just killing Kongar, it seemed like, and getting the token rather than fighting heroes. And I almost think that might have been the backfire there in the midst of that fight, but... Can't hear what I'm saying. You're lagging. So you can't hear me at all?
I hear like really bad. I can't really hear what you're saying.
Okay. Hey, let me try and recall him real quick. All right. Well, in the meantime, though, they do push in the middle lane. Is that better? Hello? All right. I think Skype's being wonky here. Anyways, in the end, Puppet Master gets saved. And it's going to be fun. Hello, can you hear me?
I can hear you. Like, it's still lagging, though.
Hey, how about you, you try calling me, and we'll see if that works. The more heads, the merrier. See if you can call me. Yeah, it sounds fine on our end, obviously, but... Hello?
Hello?
Hello.
Can you hear me?
I can hear you just fine. Can you hear me or no?
I can hear you. Can you hear me?
It seems like... Okay. Yeah, it seems like we're having some issues here. Yeah, it looks like we're fine, so... Yes, it... Alright, well... Yeah, I think it might be something on his side there as far as the internet issue, so I'll... I'll keep in touch with him, though, to see where he says, I don't know, so. Maybe it's just Skype in general being bad. Alright, well, we'll finish off with the solo here for the time being. Until, to maybe, get that looked at and figured out going into the next game. But anyways, here we go. They're going to try to push it. BMG kind of going all in right here. Madman, in the meantime, Puppet Show comes out. And Madman basically... Well, he just kind of stood there because of the crowd control and nothing more he could do. Red Shack gets a bat blast off, but it's just too late. He's on the run here in the end. Fuzi's in a lot of trouble. Drunken Master's going to go down. Fuzi jumps back in. That should probably do it, though. Reason Gaming will take game number one over Bad Monkey Gaming in a best of three. Wow. I mean, again, you go into this matchup here, as far as the standings are concerned, you had the top team in BMG. They had yet to even lose a game, let alone a series through four series. They had 2-0 to all their opponents so far. And they're going up against Razor, who's at the bottom of the list. Through three games, they've only picked up 2 points. Yet, in the end, they come out on top, and they take game number one here in this best set of three. So, obviously, congratulations to them. But it is a best set of three in the end. So, definitely have at least one, if not two more games to go. Here in this series, but BMG, going to be interesting to see the response right there. But, again, though, BMG, they not only clawed back, but they then were in the favorites, and it seemed like with their late-game potential, that was going to be deadly, but at bottom there was a bottom fight as they're pushing in, and then I think it was when they were trying to trade. I mean, they were kind of counter-pushing the top lane while their bottom